accused of sending explosive packages in the US mail, now in custody. What mistake led to his arrest, and could there be more bombs in transit? We'll break it down. Also, 18 people are expected to be charged over the murder of Washington Post journalist Jamal Khashoggi. But Saudi Arabia says it won't extradite them. And rockets in the sky over Israel. After 24 hours of sharp hostilities between Israel and Gaza militants, Palestinian sources tell CNN that a ceasefire has been broken. Hello, I'm Lynda Kinkade. Welcome to CNN Newsroom. We begin with the serial mail bomb investigation in the US. Federal authorities say they've got the suspect in custody, but warn that more devices could still be out there. 56-year-old Cesar Sayoc is in a Florida detention center, and he's due to face court on Monday. He is accused of sending 14 pipe bombs to prominent Democratic figures, as well as CNN and intelligence, former intelligence officers. Police also impounded his white van plastered with pro-Trump images. And we're now learning that's where investigators believe Sayoc was making the mail bombs. Well, our Joe Johns gets us up to speed on the investigation.
A nationwide manhunt ending with an arrest in connection to this week's mail bombs. 56-year-old Cesar Sayoc facing federal charges and up to 48 years in prison. The Justice Department announcing they were able to track Sayoc to Plantation, Florida through evidence gleaned from at least one of the packages.
They uncovered a latent fingerprint from one of the envelopes containing an IED that had been sent to Congresswoman Maxine Waters.
At least 14 pipe bombs were mailed to Democratic politicians and high-profile activists. Two of those sent care of CNN's offices in New York. Four more devices were discovered Friday, and the FBI director warns that more packages may still be on the way.
Today's arrest doesn't mean we're all out of the woods.
Sayoc has an extensive criminal history dating all the way back to the early 1990s, including a 2002 threat to blow up a utility company, suffering a fate worse than 9/11. A law enforcement official says Sayoc was initially cooperative and claimed he did not intend to harm anyone. Although none of the devices actually exploded, Ray insisted the bombs be taken seriously.
These are not hoax devices. They did contain energetic material, which, if subjected to the right combination of heat or shock or friction, could be dangerous to the public.
Details in the criminal complaint show some of the bombs included photographs of the targets with a red X across their face. Another key piece of evidence in the investigation, this white van seized during the arrest. Authorities say Sayoc was living in it after being kicked out of his parents' house. It's plastered with pro-Trump images and one CNN sucks sticker, a popular crowd chant at Trump rallies. Sayoc was even captured on video at one Trump event last year holding a CNN sucks sign, and his social media accounts are filled with memes attacking the same targets the bombs were addressed to.